You survived the weather, and you're here at the Blazor Puzzle. I'm Carl Franklin from AppVNX. That's Jeff Fritz from Microsoft. Hey, Jeff.
How do? Good to see you, Carl.
Doing okay. I'm freezing my tuchus off up here in the Northeast, but at least...
It turned to rain for us, and everything's starting to melt, and we got that. We have that snow subliming effect going on.
Yep.
Right? It's like 7 o'clock at night, and there's fog in the backyard.
And I don't know which is worse, the ice or the mud.
Oh.
The mud is so deep that I saw a guy up to his waist, and I said, I can't believe you're walking in this. He says, no, I'm on a horse.
Now, as somebody who has a few horses, they are pretty tall here, okay? Yeah.
Like, whoa. That's why it's funny, yeah.
What's scary about the fog is the dog freaks out at it because the light coming through the fog, the dog doesn't know what's going on. So they're going crazy. What is that?
Yeah. All right, let's get to last week's puzzle.
Let's do it.
Yeah. All right, so this is a .NET 8 Blazor web app with the interactive render mode set to WebAssembly and the interactivity location set to global, but that doesn't really matter. The puzzle be the same for any kind of Blazor app.
Okay.
Blazor web apps don't allow you to use the not found section in the routes razor to handle 404 errors. You know how in the old app razor you could have the found for the router and then not found if it doesn't find a route?
Yeah.
Well, you can't do that now. It doesn't work at all in a Blazor web app. So the question was, how can we implement a 404 page handler or a 404 handler in a Blazor web app?
Yeah, I want to have a nice fail whale image, right? HTTP status dog pop up there.
Yep.
How do we do that?
So the first thing we need is a page, because we're going to redirect to a page when there's a 404, right? So for that, I'm going to add a new page. I'm going to call it status code. And status code is going to accept an integer code, which I have as a parameter, int code. And I'm going to check to see if it's a 404 or a 500 or an unknown error, right? And now the key is, well, okay, but how do we redirect to this when the page isn't found? I mean, that's kind of the whole thing, right?
Yeah. Mm. I mean, isn't there an error page in the server components? There's a shared error page there, isn't there? But that's if you have a 500 error, something errors out on your page. It formats and delivers this thing, but you're talking about an HTTP error.
Yeah,
code.
I'm talking about, oops, that page is not here. So here's how you do it.
All right.
So in program CS on the server, after you have an app, you simply do this. app.useStatusCodePages with redirects, and you pass it to your status code with whatever the error is. And that's how you do it.
All right, so status code you made as a WebAssembly thing, so it's going to render that with all the pre-rendering goodness that we now have in Blazor with .NET 8, and it's going to be able to route appropriately and pass in whatever HTTP status code that was detected.
You got it.
Let's take a look.
Yeah. Okay, so there's home, here's counter. And now if I just add some blotty blah to the end of counter.
Sure.
Here's what happens. There it is.
Page not found.
Status code /404. And of course, you could say whatever you want to here. You can have your own goofy graphics and whatever.
So this reminds me, like back in the day, like 10 years ago back in the day.
Yeah.
I wrote a NuGet package that did this for .NET 4.5.
Okay.
And it's called fritz.http status cats. And it puts up the HTTP status cats photos if you have for the appropriate HTTP status error code on your ASP.NET framework website. But feels like somebody could do something similar to have fun with this. But it's great that we know how to reach in now and put in all of our custom status pages.
Right. Yeah. The key is that line in program that I didn't even know was there, that you could do that on the app.
It turns out there's a handful of similar lines that allow you to set up various error handling and status code interactions.
Oh, yeah. Goody. Those will make some great future puzzles, won't they?
Don't forget global error handling, too.
Yeah. Well, we got a few really good answers, correct answers.
Loved seeing the documentation from some of these folks. They were really thorough in how they explained their solutions.
Yeah. These are smart people that watch this show.
I can't believe we have smart people watching this show.
I know, right?
Watching us.
Now the key is to have smart people doing the show. That would be even better, wouldn't it?
Wait. Okay.
I'm talking about myself. I don't know who you were thinking of, but.
Steve, you want to do a show? Steve. I don't think Steve can hear
busy.
Me.
Yeah. All right. So this week's winner is, drum roll, please, Mark Harwood from the UK.
Yes. Congratulations, Mark.
Yeah. And Mark, for having his answer selected at random from all the right answers we got, is going to win one of these, a Blazor Puzzle Mug, in which he can have his tea every day at 4 p.m. with some crumpets. And he's also going to win one of these, a Blazor Puzzle t-shirt.
Nice.
Yep.
Let your friends know that you're a winner of the Blazor Puzzle.
Correct. And wow, that was a good one. So let's dive into next week's puzzle.
All right. So, Carl, this one, I don't really have code to show because this is more of a theoretical thing.
Yeah.
I ran into an issue. I've been publishing and working on a website that I built with Blazor static site rendering. Mm-hmm. And when we build our websites with Blazor, we know how to start up and put together all these great components to render quickly and put together amazing user interface. Mm-hmm. But in my case, I ended up with a bunch of JavaScript files and a bunch of CSS files laying around. Mm-hmm. And as I ran the Google search engine optimization analysis against it, right, their mm-hmm. Lighthouse tool and a couple of other things, it came back and said, you've got uncompressed CSS, you've got too many JavaScript files laying around. And it got me thinking back, we used to bundle and compress and minify this stuff.
Yeah. Like,
That's a thing that for a while we were doing with Webpack and Gulp and Grunt. Mm-hmm. Carl, I'm done with the JavaScript tools.
Yeah,
right?
Me too.
I'm chasing them constantly, and if it's not my community and my tool set that I'm familiar
with. That's right.
With.
I mean, we're so, Blazor here. We speak C sharp.
Yeah.
As little JavaScript as possible. That's our motto.
I don't keep up with their changes. It's not the news that I'm watching. I'm listening to .NET podcasts. I don't know if you know one or two really good ones out there.
I've heard of a couple, yeah.
Okay. Mm. So is there a tool or something that we can use to minify and bundle our CSS and JavaScript to help make our Blazor sites more, I don't want to say just production ready, but internet facing ready.
Yeah, that's right. The search engines will roll right over you if you've got too many CSS files.
Yeah. So viewers out there, can you help us out? Can you give us a tool? Can you give us a reference? Can you give us some techniques?
We want to see some code.
Give us a little bit of code to help minify and bundle CSS and JavaScript using C# and .NET code.
Absolutely. That ought to keep him busy for a week.
Maybe at least a week? Maybe?
At least.
Okay. All right.
Now, if you think you know the answer, don't post it on social media, but instead send it to Jeff and me at blazorpuzzle@appvnext.com with the subject puzzle number 21.
All right.
And we will be looking forward to checking out your solutions next week on the Blazor Puzzle. In the meantime, don't take any wooden nickels.
Don't do that.
Yeah. See you next week.
Take care, friends.
Bye. Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out blazortrain.com and the .NET show.com for more great content.